think people in PC mode, that with the PC mode, they can't go in VR. That's a lot. That's a.
Okay. Hello, everybody. Yes, you did. Oh, shit. I didn't just do that, really. I just exited VR by accident. I was in the menu changing some settings, and I hit exit VR chat instead of menu closing. Yeah, exactly. All right, I'm loading back in. This is ridiculous. I believe I did something so stupid as that. That's all right. I got it. I'm straight now. Come on, machine. All right. Let me reopen my camera. Actually, you know what? I'm going to use my ninja avatar. Why not? Hello, everybody. All right. Make sure my screen looks the way it's supposed to. Yes, I do believe we're good. And I am going to turn Miku on now so everybody can hear Miku.
Hello, everybody on Mike's channel.
Performance mode. That should clean up some issues. All right. I am on my... I'm about to send you a...
Oh, wait. I'm still on red.
Okay. That's fine. I am going to go red, actually. And then I'm going to click on you as soon as you switch out. There we go.
Oh, let me see. It's on blue.
All right. There you go. And when I get there, you can go back red.
Yep. If you're wondering how you're actually hearing them right now, we're on Discord talking to each other. Then when he gets into this game, we're going to, when he gets here, we're going to turn off Discord so we're not hearing each other twice.
There we go. Did you get my invite or my request?
It never pops up when you're on blue.
Oh. Let me see if I can send it
again. You just have to, the only thing you can do is just join.
It won't let me. It just says required invite.
I think it's because you're on red.
Okay, that's probably why. You're right. You're right. I'll go blue till I get where you are, and then we can both go back.
Yeah, red has a very specific thing about it. You could join people.
There we go.
But you can't get invites or send invites and join them that way because...
On my way.
Red is really particular.
Well, and as you guys could probably see there, my home world is the same as Miku's home world, but we just have separate. It would be nice if VR chat would add a feature where you can invite other close friends to also be in your home world.
In the same world together, so everything could be a lot more
simpler. I just think it would be a lot easier for good friends to meet up quicker without having to go through all the extra running around, but hey, it works. This world is really cool where Miku is here. Alright, I'm going to end the Discord.
Yeah, me too. There we go. Got Mike Ninja in his ninja uniform outfit.
Yes, now, I was about to say about this world, it's really cool. The world is so large that when you enter the world, you can come up to this panel that's here on the wall, and it's right here next to the pool at the entrance. And it shows who's in the world. And you can literally select their name from this list and teleport to them. So the bottom floor, if you watched one of Miku's last streams, she did a tour of this house. And the bottom floor of this house has a large dance club. And we're probably going to have some events here in the future. And when we do, you enter this world, instead of having to hunt all over the place for us, because this world has 6 floors, and the dance club is in the basement. So when you enter the world, you can come here, find a friend, and instantly teleport to them. And that'll take you usually to the club where everybody else is located.
Or if you just want to, just pick on a random name and just
click on them
and you just teleport where they are and everybody will be there anyway. So
Right. So, but it when we do events, it's always a Friends Plus event. So you enter the world, come to this panel, pick somebody from the list and teleport to them. And then you can move on about your business around the club where we're all hanging out. So, how you doing, Miku?
Good.
So Miku is in PC mode, so she doesn't have a camera that she can actually link to the stream like I do. But hopefully by the end of this month, she will have VR, hopefully, if things go as planned. And she'll be able to do her stream just like I am, if her computer wants to act right. And her internet. So yeah, I have my camera up here so they can see me in a little window on my screen. And
and especially if you want to know, he's the one who bought me this avatar.
Yes, sweet Miku, yes. Is worth it. So you guys go follow Miku. If you're not already following her, it is under Hot Miku Bot at Twitch, and she's also on YouTube. So check her out there, and don't forget to join her Discord for any event information that might be coming up. And you hear my voice coming across her speakers because she's got a pretty messed up headset. So unfortunately, she has to use her TV for audio. So excuse the doubled up voice.
It would have been a lot worse if we had the Discord still on. It'd be tripled.
Yes, it would. So, all right. So, where are we headed? We can go anywhere you want if you got some ideas.
Not really sure. Where should we go?
We can. I can do.
There's so many worlds out there. Makes it kind of confused on. Makes it kind of hard on knowing where you want to go.
Wow, there's another big event thing going on in VR chat right now. Oh, never mind.
Oh.
It's basically the same thing that the VR con was. It's like a huge marketplace kind of thing that they've got going on. Right now, Virtual Market 2021, it's called. But we can check out some other things. Miku and I are part of a group of DJs called Spooky Ninja Productions, and we put on events in VR chat at different dance clubs that are around. It's a great place to meet people. I prefer not to go to public locations to meet people because you never really know what you're getting in that situation. But when you go to club events where they have DJs all night long playing music, there's all kinds of really cool people. You stand a really high chance of meeting people that are streamers on Twitch and YouTube as well when you go to those events.
Yeah, I got several friends that are streamers themselves.
And It's really a really cool way to meet people that you know are trustable people, because all of those people in these clubs are required to have manners, basically. You know, when you go to public worlds, you tend to end up in a situation sometimes where people just don't care what they say and do. So, you know, you have to kind of Oh, we need to go back red, by the way.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's a huge thing in a lot of public worlds, not to mention a lot of children running around and just all kinds of things that are not great for meeting people. And if you really want to meet some cool people and a lot of cool, if you like dance music or any kind of music for that matter, there's many, many, many dance clubs and events going on all through the week and on the weekends in VR chat. And it's a lot of fun to hang out in those locations if you like music. If you're not really into music, you know, there are other things to do in VR chat, but I particularly prefer meeting people in those venues because you tend to not have issues with the people you meet there later on down the road. There's a lot less mischief going on, put it like that.
And FYI, these dance clubs are 18 and up.
Yes, that
no
well
exceptions.
Our both of our streams are 18 and up as well. So if you're in the stream and you're not 18, you probably shouldn't be, because all most of the people that I know have 18 plus streams, and you know, and same goes for our Discords. But please, if you are 18 plus, definitely join our Discords. Check it out. It is really the best way to find out about events in VR chat, because we all post events there. And there's also several Discords out there that advertise specifically events that are going on in VR chat. And a lot of them are linked to my Discord. So you'll get a lot of that information in my, self-promote section and several other areas when something's going on that's really big. And a lot of times the details on how to join those events are listed in their postings. So it's a lot of fun to do. I'm a DJ. Miku helps us out by streaming the events now, and helps us keep things organized when it comes to making sure people aren't going in places that they shouldn't be, things of that nature, which, you know, it's typical. You're going to run into some folks who just don't care and do things that shouldn't be done. And you got to have people running around making sure that things are on the up and up, you know. So, but otherwise, it's a great way to meet people in general, by going to these events. And a lot of these people, some of these people are famous people that are huge in Twitch and YouTube, as well as some really, really famous DJs that are out there IRL DJing at clubs and huge events all over the world. And they come into VR chat just to do these things sometimes. So, I can't name any names, but there are quite a few out there that DJ in here for free, as well as do concerts and shows all over the place, all over the world. So it's pretty cool and an amazing way to meet really cool people. So I'm just looking through the list.
Friends, X just dance out in public. Thanks, Robin Villa. The chicken in the meeting is Walter Huggs is one of them.
Yep, and he's a really, really popular Twitch streamer, and he's in VR all the time. He's a good friend of ours. You guys can check them out as well on Twitch. They're really cool, but there's a lot of people that we know that we've met through these events that we have. And so let's see, what shall it be today? We found some really cool worlds last time we did this, last weekend.
There are some people that you can end the meeting that is not as cool as others. I'm
true.
Not saying a specific person is one that we actually know of. I'm not saying this person's name.
Yeah, there are a few people that aren't as friendly as we would like, put it like that. But that's typical.
Basically, just pretend and find out their true colors because they...
It happens in the world of Twitch. Stardom can go to your head. Gee whiz.
Well, it's based on a person, really.
True. But there are a lot of really cool ones. In fact, probably more cool ones than others. Oh.
Like an Iron Mouse.
She's really cool.
And Zentraya.
I've never met those people. Miku has. She's met them before.
Yeah, I met other streamers in the past. I'm not saying who, because I don't want to make people jealous.
Yeah.
That's all I need.
All right. What about beach stuff? You want to go to some beach worlds?
Oh, okay.
Just for the heck of it, I'll just search for beaches. Let's see what we can find. This really cool. Some of these I've never been to before, so I'm just going to randomly pick something.
Imagine actual beach world known as Randomly Something. Fully named that. That would be a really ironic one.
Yes, it would. I can't drop a portal here. Lovely. We're right here at the spawn spot.
Yeah, if you're too close to a spawn place, well, you can't actually land a portal anywhere near one. In some worlds, you can't even drop a portal at all. So you have to teleport there.
Yes, now that's another thing about these events. A lot of the event people require no portals being dropped in the event, because unless they drop the portal themselves, because they would rather you just, like you see in this menu I'm looking at, just set up your world and hit go and then have your other friends follow you.
In the past, they had these people that were being mean and just teleported people into Uganda world.
Oh, Lordy. So, anyway, when you're in the portals teleporting, you can't talk to each other. So, until it loads back in, then everybody will pop back in to the microphone. So, whoa.
That's those people that constantly just teleport you into the Uganda world or other worlds just for the fun of it. It was just completely rude.
Never have I
but
ever
it's
ball.
It's funny when it actually backfires.
So this is a cool little beach world. Really pretty.
Never have I ever.
Yeah. What are these balls?
Not sure. Only one way to find out.
Object noise. World sounds.
Oh, that one turns on seats that you can actually...
I'm going to turn off the world music just because I never know about that kind of stuff.
Beach ball.
Cool little place with some pins. There's some more portals back here. Rain loft and the top floor. Oh, hold up.
Top floor, that sounds interesting.
There's a kitty cat in here purring.
It's a sliding door. You just click on it.
A real kitty cat. Purring.
How cute.
This is pretty nice. I've never been here before. This is really cool. Purring from that kitty cat is really loud. Oh, you can sit on the rail. That's kind of neat.
I'm railed.
Oh, wow.
Marshmallows.
Really cool stuff. I'm going to turn down avatar volume. World volume is fine. This is nice.
Look at all the crystals in this cave.
What is this, a mirror? Yeah.
Yep, it's just a mirror.
This is kind of a small little world, but it's really pretty, actually.
Nice and tranquil, pretty much.
Yeah.
That's a little dock over here for some... And then a ball that... Probably does something.
Probably a mirror. Yep, another mirror.
Yep, it's a mirror. Based on the type of avatar you go with, yeah, some this, of them with facial is, animations like what his character does, and sometimes his specific
yeah, my
facial
eyes
animations
are a little messed
makes
up.
Him look creepy.
But this is one of the avatars. You were speaking about avatars that you bought, that I bought. This is one of my avatars that I uploaded, that I purchased. I originally purchased this one because Mike Ninja 620. Hence the ninja thing. So it was kind of something, but it's not complete. It's just the basic deal. And I was planning on putting some logos and some other artwork on it. And I just haven't, you know, been able to do that. I'm no good at it, to be honest. I don't create avatars. But I know some people that...
Essentially, he doesn't have... enough time to make avatars. He already has enough, and it's
I got so much going on. But I am eventually going to get this one fixed up and readjusted and things. So, but I thought I would wear it today because it just, it's kind of, this is kind of really my first VR chat stream in general. I'm on a Quest 2 with the link cable. So, if you're going to buy a Quest 2 and you have a PC, I highly recommend getting that cable. It is definitely, good grief, that world audio is insane. I highly recommend it. Don't not get it, because if you've already spent the $300 or $400 on the system, go ahead and spend the extra $50 to $80 for the link cable. It's just worth the money, and you'll appreciate it better because you can see everything and do everything that anybody else can do that has full VR or PC. So it's just, I mean, if you've already spent the money, you know, it's pointless not to go ahead and spend the extra $100 to get whatever else you need to make it comfortable and work well. But if you don't have a PC and you want a good standalone system, the Quest 2 is also great for that. But there are limits when you have it that way. But it is recommended to get that link cable. So Miku will have a Quest 2 hopefully by the end of the month. So it'll be cool. She'll be able to do what I do now. And I have full body, but I really honestly just don't use it. And I'm probably going to be doing something else with that in the future. I'll probably be upgrading it to something a little different. Maybe even a whole different VR system at some point. But right now, I just really don't have a use for it. But anyway.
And if you're wondering about my name, Miku Tura, it's simple. Two favorite characters I like. Miku Hatsune Miku, and the other one is Tura from the Soul Calibur series. I didn't decide a name for a specific reason. I just like the characters. That's it. So I just went with the names.
I was adjusting my screen stuff. Hey, Princess Nori, how are you?
Oh, okay.
Sorry it took me so long to get to you. I didn't have my chat up. But bear with me a second. I'm going to pop
yeah,
out
he
my...
Yeah, I was having technicalities that was kind of getting in the way.
I'm going to pop out my chat so that I can see my chat real quick.
I have my chat thing, but I never heard anybody put anything up yet.
Yeah, I didn't have mine up, so now I will. I don't know why this is not connecting. Oh, I know why that's not working. I'm going to have to re-log in to my Twitch on my my Twitch on my phone.
Oh, okay.
At this point, let me get my chat window. There we go. Now I got you guys up here where I can see you.
And that thing, if they end up wondering someday, not sure when, it could be many day, a long time, but eventually, walking through people will be impossible to do anymore.
That would be awesome, to be honest. That's something that I've been hoping that they would do for a long time, but I haven't really heard anything about them actually doing it. But I'm sure people have been suggesting this. And the thing is it would be really easy to do. All they would have to do is add another checkbox in the settings in VR chat that you could turn that on and off. And that way, some people can be walked through and others can't. That would make a huge difference, I think, in those folks out there who... Now, you can set your settings... settings does have a setting for like your space, your virtual space, which prevents people from getting close to you in certain ways, but that also prevents other things from happening in the game, which a lot of people like to have available. But so if you check that box, matter of fact, it is... personal space in your comfort and safety settings, that will actually prevent people from getting within a certain distance of you. It's fine for those folks out there who have issues with phantom touch and don't want people walking through them or touching them. But it also prevents those folks out there who do... like head pats and hugs, it can't be done with those people that have that active. So, but the feature that we're talking about would be something that they would have to implement totally separately, which would give each person a solid body, and you should be able to turn that on and off, because I'm sure there'll be certain bugs they'll have to work out of it. So having the ability to activate it and deactivate it would, you know, be a helpful situation. But as I said, I haven't heard anything definite about anybody even doing such. So don't quote us on that, because we don't know for sure if that'll ever happen. But it would be really cool.
Well, if it does happen, it'll be cool. If it doesn't happen, well...
Yeah.
Oh, well.
You know, but that would be something that would be really nice to have that option, you know. So, anyway.
Maybe just like walking forward instead of walking right through something, you could just walk right into people like you're walking into a wall.
Yeah. Now, objects like this is fine to be able to walk through, but when you walk to a person in a crowded room and you need to get by, some people will just zoop right through people. And there's people out there that don't particularly care for that too much, especially if they have phantom sense. It makes them feel really weird, and, you know, but as I said, we don't know if that's ever going to come up, but it would be a really cool feature, I think. It would also give people the ability to walk up, if you have hand effects part of it built in, to actually walk up and physically hug someone without passing through their body.
Without your arms and stuff, yeah, going right through them.
But it would, yeah, it would also be...
At this moment, I could just do this, and it looks weird.
Yeah, so there's a point that it may be possible in the future. At this point, I don't know that it's exactly possible, because not only would it have to be a feature that VR Chat implements, it would also have to be a feature that's implemented in the avatar itself. So it would be something that... some script that would have to be added to the avatar to give their body. I don't know if you would classify it as bones, just like your hair movement and things like that, but it would be something that you would give your character a hitbox. But that also would be determined by the size of the character. So if you got a really, really tiny character, your hitbox may be the size of a full-size character like us, so you walk up to them and it still wouldn't work. So that would be tough to implement. You know, that it would be something that they would really have to work on.
They have to literally go into the program themselves when they make the avatar and shrink it the size of the small avatar so you
right.
can only walk over the avatar.
Yeah, it would be an extra step in avatar creation, and it should be an option that you can also turn on and off in Unity when you're uploading the character. That would be a cool way of doing it, is make it a script that you can download for Unity, so when you do the upload, you can just check a box and say you want that avatar to have that ability, and it will just wrap that ability around the character. Now, that's easier said than done, of course. But
and that's a good reason for to have that ability be a thing, because of a certain reason, is based on specific avatars.
Right.
They got things that... that a kid should not be seen and able to walk through the avatars.
It's something
pretty awkward.
It's something that would have other repercussions, I guess you could say. So
yes,
you want to pick a different place, Miku, that we can check out? You're welcome to choose something. Well, we'll just kind of rotate back and forth if you want. Just any old world that we haven't ever been to, that'll be cool. Just make sure you set it up for the highest security, invite only or whatever. That way, cool. All right. After you. And away we go. There's a lot of worlds that I haven't actually seen, you know, so it's something that I've been wanting to check out, a lot of these places, for a long time. Oh, wow, it's a crisp... Oh! It's Disney. MGM Studios with a Christmas theme. Because there's Tower of...
This is the place a friend actually took me to.
The Tower of Terror is back there. I wonder if you can actually go to it, can you?
You can actually put the Tower of Terror surrounded... That you can actually be in a place surrounded with gingerbread houses.
This is Disney Hollywood Studios. well, Christmas town, I guess they created. Pretty cool. Oh, sorry, closed. They haven't opened it yet. Well,
yeah, the Tower of Terror place is off limits for now until they get finished.
That'll be cool, though. Really awesome.
So basically, when this place gets finished, my friend will actually open it up, and you can go into their own version of a Tower of Terror.
That is really cool.
Yeah, I know.
Pretty sweet. All right. So this stream is actually working a lot better for me at this point.
Some of the places don't have much in them, but there are other ones with actual... There is one that I actually know of that has avatars.
Oh, yeah, there are some avatars over here. Oh, Lord, a Nintendo avatar.
Yeah, if you want to be the Nintendo symbol, this is where you can go. Or you could be Elsa with skeleton thing on it, on her.
That's interesting.
You could be a black and white cat girl. Literally.
Pretty neat. Hey, Nori, don't you have an avatar that looks a lot like her?
Probably, not sure.
I think I saw her wearing something similar to that a while back.
And this one is an SCP.
Oh, Lord.
Cuddle monster.
Oh, boy. What else we got here? This is pretty cool, though. I'm gonna move this over here. That way it's not in my view completely. I think I'm going to move this camera over to this side. That way I can see everything a lot better. Have a little less stuff in the way, I guess you could say.
Kind of seems like the other buildings don't have anything in them except one? Well, they're creating this place, so it's understandable, really.
Yeah. This was pretty cool. Yeah, they still got some work to do on this place. Of course, it isn't quite Christmas yet, and they still got some time to finish it.
Yeah, they got a good amount of days before Christmas pops in, and so, yeah.
So let's see. I'll see if I can create something here. Where to go? We'll try, after Miku gets her VR, we'll do some things like maybe some Beat Saber or something like that.
Yep, some person out there actually made the Beat Saber world. Made a world for Beat Saber in VR chat.
It's really cool, too. I've actually played... I think there's more than one, because I'm pretty sure that I have played in two different locations in here. Christmas
and VR. Of course,
the
Beat Saber the Beat Saber game itself has way more songs built for it, because, well... That's all it is, because it's the actual main game, but VR chat has a limit.
Yeah.
The songs they actually went with.
Yeah.
It's like the MMD worlds.
zombie tag.
I'm a zombie. I'm gonna tag you.
So much stuff in here. Andromeda.
It's like almost every day a new world is being created or is already made.
Well, there's lots of other really cool homes in VR chat. So, what do you have in mind, Miku? Anything in particular?
I have no idea. So many worlds in this game, it's confusing on which way to go.
Interesting. I don't know what this is, but we'll check it out. Why not? Called Super Lofty, or a Lo-Fi, Super Lo-Fi, something or other. I don't know. We'll see. We'll check it out. Why not? Whoa.
Whoa. Why ain't this freaking something?
It's just kind of a chill out world. Chair.
Looks impressive if it asks me. Okay.
Oh, there's a pool table.
Oh, okay.
Chair. Oh, it took the chairs away.
Can I actually open a portal?
Mystery Fox map. Interesting. Huh, let's see something. Close that for now. Case. That's pretty neat. Ain't much to it, though. Very small little place, but kind of cool. Let's see what else we got in here.
Definitely what you call advanced on the way it looks, though.
There's also golf, like mini golf worlds that are really fun to do when you have some VR to do it. I've played it actually on PC. It is possible. It's just not as easy.
What do you think about this?
Hmm. Let's see. Let's check it out. Sounds cool to me. Oh, and if you notice, my load-in world is red instead of green like everybody else. It's just a color change. You can adjust certain colors with some specific ways. It goes back green when you get to a certain point. There is still some lag.
Hello. Ain't this something?
Oh, that's interesting.
English, Korean, Japanese.
English.
Wow.
Oh, wow. This is a game, I do believe.
Oh, okay.
Let's see here. Can I be supported after joining? Use. There we go.
Okay.
The hell?
Whoa. Hey, this freaking something.
Oh, wow, you can fly. Woo, it's fast, no doubt. You got a sword. It's like Gundam. You're flying around like a Gundam. Oh, no way. This is crazy. Oh shit, I'm stuck. How do I turn? Oh, there we go. Where did she go? You fight each other.
Oh.
I think. I don't know. Maybe not.
I pushed this thing and now it says S EX stage level stage or stage.
Well, stage. All right, there's a battle mission. Training center. All right, so I guess we gotta go out and attack some shit. Not sure exactly. Whoa. I'm a bit confused. Oh! Okay. Whoa. So, are we supposed to be attacking each other? Oh, here we go.
Oh. Guns.
Oh, okay.
Target practice. Got them all.
Yeah. That's interesting. Huh. Oh, all right. Complete. Cleared the first level. Stage 2. More training. We're going to access stage 2. Boop.
Now, there we go. Feel a lot of charge. something.
Yeah. Oh.
Grab one of those bombs and just put it, just walk into the wall with, just put it against the wall.
Oh, shit. There's different kinds of guns. Oh, can't use those. All right.
You gotta pick up the bomb.
Okay. Interesting. Oh, okay.
It's just target practice. That's all this is.
Yeah. All right. So we go to the other thing on the end and teleport back out.
And that one's done.
Complete that. Okay, real shooting.
Real shooting.
I don't have a gun.
And we just had to, oh, we gotta grab a gun.
Where's the guns? I don't even see any. I'm confused. I'm confused completely.
Me too.
I don't see an exit.
Supposed to do. We were supposed to grab a gun before we came in here.
Oh, lovely. We're gonna have to respawn. Where's the guns?
Yeah, but how am I supposed to grab a gun?
I don't see any guns. Yeah, I'm a bit confused with that. Ridiculous.
Oh, that was ridiculous, I guess.
Yeah. Well, what else is in the list? Oh, you can't do anything till you complete those. Oh, well. Oh, well.
Well, we can go back to number two and just, hope if we can carry the gun with us?
Maybe so. Maybe. Says cleared, though, but there's no button on it.
Well, that sucks.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah, that's messed up. Oh, well. I guess we'll find something else. That's kind of...
Oh, it was kind of... It was
fun. It was pretty cool, though. This is really a cool idea.
Yeah.
Let's see what else we got. That was really neat. Good choice. They should have had some guns out here for you to grab.
Yeah, no kidding.
Kill shot. That's really interesting. Listen at you over there munching. I wish I had some snackaroos. Let's see here. What else we got here? Random. Look under the random category. Camp in the mountains.
Camp under the sandwiches.
Dragon's Tavern. City of Stars. Silent Hill.
Silent underwear.
My underwear are always silent. Yuki's Christmas Cinema. Space junk.
Are they eating that space junk again?
Crystal Hall.
A crystal mall.
Spookalities. Huh. There was a cool escape room thing that I wish I knew what it was called. You had to do some puzzle stuff to figure it out.
Well, you always prepare to escape and see what we get.
True. Let's see.
Escape your psychotic girlfriend. Escape The zombies escape the ball of doom.
Sci-fi escape. Let's see.
Escape the giant worm trying to eat you.
Yeah, sure. Pop escape.
Escape your sanity.
Yeah. Requiem 17. Escape the security room. Come on. There's too many things with escape in it. And I don't see the one I'm actually looking for.
Escape the Monkey Foo Fighter!
Well, let's just check out All right, let's try this.
Escape the chupacabra is trying to chew on you. Ooh.
Okay, let's try this. What the heck?
Okay.
Let's see what this is when it is. Escape the library. Why not?
That sounds interesting. Live in a library.
All right, there are 30 objects that will open the door and set you free. I suggest waiting for everyone to spawn before collecting. Desktop users might not be able to collect all of them. Lovely.
That's why it's good that you're here.
Yeah. Okay, so let's see. I found a book.
This is an impressively big area. One error.
I got two. Oh, I found a few.
Me too.
Yeah.
Looks so freaking pretty.
Yeah, they did a heck of a job on this thing.
Anything right now? They could be anywhere. Yahtzee is in my nose.
What we got here? Nothing.
I got a Yahtzee in my nose.
Oh my. Found another book. See what's up here. Interesting. Nothing up here so far.
I haven't found anything else.
No. There's something. Even in the closed cases, it'll have books that can be grabbed.
Need to keep on grabbing things until that all those stars next to the door just.
Yeah, that's what I was looking at. Okay, I got everything from up here, I think. I just got to check through some of these cases that are closed. Okay. All right, I found more books. Uh-oh. The painting on the wall for that one.
We're getting lower on stars. Awesome.
Some of the paintings on the walls will work as well.
One of them was a statue.
Interesting. How many we got left? I have overlooked something somewhere. Goodness. That sounded ruffola. I have missed something somewhere here.
It's a lot of things we just still haven't found.
Plants? Check the plants. I don't know if any of these lights do anything. Don't think so.
Always one good. There's only one way to find out. Just check.
Okay, let's see. What about these on the floor? No.
So many objects, it's just trying to like find a bunch of needles in a haystack.
Yeah. Interesting. Candlesticks. Ah, this one. In a haystack. There was a light. There was a light. This is crazy. Oh, another book on the top shelf.
It's not many left, but where they are, no clue.
Another story. Yeah, this is interesting, to say the least. Ow. Hit my hand on the wall. Ah, this big statue. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 more.
The 7 left could be anywhere, really.
Yeah. Well, I found another one. 6 left. Huh.
Okay, this is confusing, but if it wasn't a puzzle game, if it wasn't some kind of searching game, it would make no point in it not being confusing.
Well, that's not that book. Wondering about these candlesticks, but I can't get close enough to them to... God dang it.
Yeah, they're kind of out of the way?
Yeah. Alright, let's see. I wonder if any of these chairs... Hey, I found another book. Five more items. Oh, there was something. four more.
Okay, there's only four left.
Three more.
Oh, okay.
Huh.
Nothing there.
Interesting. Let me go up here a second. One of these inner pedestals.
Okay.
Very confusing.
Yeah, no kidding.
I thought maybe the candlesticks, if you can get up there onto the tops of these things, to the candlesticks.
Oh, not that one.
Shit. This is crazy.
No kidding. Oh, come on. Run out of the candles.
No. There's got to be something we've overlooked. Hey, I got something. Two left.
Yep. I already need to find the last two, wherever they are.
Okay, yeah.
This place is ridiculously pretty looking.
Yeah. Just kind of hold your hand out as I go around, and sometimes things randomly crop up. Hey, I got another one. One more. one more item. Shit.
What would you think if some of them were actually on top of those things up there?
What? On the rails? I walked around checking the rails, but I didn't see anything up there.
No, on top of the things with the books inside of them up there.
Oh, that would suck. I just think there's something. There's nothing up there. And nothing up there. One frickin' object. Well, this is starting to get old.
Yeah, no kidding.
Well, the nice thing is when you run across it, you don't have to necessarily be touching it. You just have to be aiming at it. So,
but aiming at it is the thing.
One fucking star. Shit.
Well, this is annoying.
No doubt.
Especially, what would you think if they're actually inside of the, on that statue, inside the bowl, in that female statue's hand?
I checked that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I raised myself up to look in the bowl. This is just ridiculous.
We've been everywhere. Where is this darn thing?
It's got to be another lamp or something that we're just, like, not touching. Because it vibrates if you get close to it. Like, your hand, for me, the controller vibrates when you pass something that lights
me, the
up.
The only thing I see is like this bright-ass blue light.
Blue, or for me, it's a red. The chairs aren't doing anything. Okay.
Surprisingly.
The fuck are we missing? That's got to be something that's hidden very well. I thought maybe one of these chairs.
Heck, one of them was a statue, so...
Yeah, I've got... I picked up a...
None of them are the chairs.
There it is. Got it.
Oh, now, finally.
Now what, though?
That was a pain.
Oh, shit, another room. Oh, God, another room. Oh, it's a feast.
Huh. That it?
I think so. Whoa, I got stuck in here.
Pretty much that's it.
I guess it is. Are we supposed to sit? I don't know.
I guess that was just it. Get out and you can actually...
I guess so.
There's a dumpling of food. That's interesting.
Alright, I guess that was it. There's nothing that's really lighting up for us or anything special.
This table is...
hollow.
Has no collision detection.
All right, well, what else do we have? Oh, lovely. I get no menu. Although, there it is. All right.
Ooh.
That was something.
I ate something.
Yeah, I need to go eat something.
I ate
something.
The food on the table and the table itself.
Oh, well, you know what? We only have... Hey, Techno, what's up? Sorry it took me so long to get back to you there. This was kind of crazy.
Scavenger hunts to escape a museum? Of nothing but books and all kinds of other stuff.
Yeah, Fiber. That's kind of crazy.
Literally.
Well, it's 4:43. We only got like 15 minutes or so before you end your stream, I think. Before we stop. I think it was 1 to 5, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So, yeah, we could go back to your house and chill for another 15 minutes or whatever, and then call it a night on the stream, I suppose. I'm getting kind of hungry. I need to get some food. I know that. I have not eaten today. I've been running around doing things. So...
Yeah, we can end it.
So if you want to just... you can actually, you can't drop a portal, but you can go there and then send me an invite. I'll go back blue so you can invite me.
But it won't work if I actually in red too, because I'm going to have to go to orange?
You can still invite on red. I'm pretty sure. Actually, no, let's just go orange on both of ours. You should still be able to send me an invite in orange. All right. You go ahead and invite me, and then I'll... Well, anyway, folks, I guess we're going to chill at Miku's and hang out for a while. Hold on. I'm all crooked. Myself tangled up here. Yeah, that's pretty much. Today's been kind of a chill stream. We decided to do a VR chat stream today. I think that's what our Sundays are going to be. Miku and I are scheduled for the same time frame on Sundays, 1 to 5. So we decided we'd just start doing this on Sundays. And then the rest of the week will be some other kind of game. So, I guess I might have to, there it is. All right, here we go. So yeah, we've just been kind of chilling, taking it easy today, hitting a few interesting worlds. That's pretty much what our Sundays will be. It'll just be kind of hopping around to some worlds that we might not have ever seen and other people might not have ever seen before. Just taking it easy. So this is our home world. So we was talking at the beginning of the stream that... Miku and I are using the same location as our home. The base, it's a six floor house, like a big condo called Toki's Villa. And like I was saying at the beginning, there's a teleporter system built into the front door area here in this front lobby section outside. That allows
so
people.
So if one of your friends are somewhere else and you want to get to them really quickly, you just click on their name and you just teleport to them.
You can just choose them from the list and go. And in the basement, there's a dance club, and they've added a front deck out here on the front of this place that's got a big fireworks display that. I guess it's set up for New Year's Eve. So me and Spooky were talking about doing our community event here for New Year's Eve. So we'll all start out in the basement in the club and have a big DJ thing down there. And then when it gets close to midnight, we'll all make our way up here to the pool area and watch the fireworks display. So I thought it would be kind of cool. But the place is awesome. It's a huge house. And Miku and I found this place a couple of weeks back, I guess. But it might even been a month now. And we just started. We both made this our home world.
We used to have Deco Cabin as our home until we found this big place.
Yeah, this place is really awesome. It's got pool tables. It's got a movie theater in one area. I mean, we did a little tour of it last weekend on Miku's stream. So this is my first week doing a stream in full VR, like, you know, settings. I mean, I've done the DJ thing, but it's not set up quite like this with the double camera and all of that, because I have the camera set up. And actually, where did my camera go?
It's right behind your head.
Oh, okay. Why can't I grab it? There we go.
There you go.
So yeah, I decided to set to try this week, and took me a little while to get everything set up properly, but this was kind of a test stream for me, and Miku had already had hers set up for last weekend, so hers is pretty much ready. But now when she gets her VR in a few weeks, I guess, she'll have to reset her stuff, because it's going to work a lot different once you get the headset and everything. The OBS is set up a little differently to get this camera working and all of that stuff. So it's something that I'm trying to get, you know, to be a regular thing now. So it's been cool though. I like doing this. This actually went a lot smoother than I expected. We started at 1 o'clock today. Well, Miku started at 1 o'clock today. I didn't get started till much later, because I was trying to get all this set up and working.
At least, yeah, because it's
everything was being a pain in the butt. So yeah, exactly. So I finally got it all set. And it looks like it's doing okay, I guess. I mean, I haven't really had a chance to look at my stream, but my OBS is showing that the stream is flowing smoothly, as far as I can tell. All the stats are good. So this will be something that we're going to do every Sunday, I think. This just kind of a hangout, chill session. Run around just some different worlds, see what we can come up with. And if we find anything new to check out through the week when we're in here just doing our own thing without streaming, we'll show it on the weekend and, you know, see what everybody's, you know, show everybody what VR chat's all about. And then, of course, on Tuesday nights, I will be doing the DJ thing on Untamed Tuesday, and Miku will be streaming the whole event every Tuesday on her stream. And then the rest of the nights through the week are just standard gaming nights. Me and Miku have been doing a lot together on streams. I've been trying to help her get her stuff set up and going, and she's getting the hang of things, and she's been doing really good with it. So it's awesome. Glad to see she's in there streaming. And, so hopefully we'll be doing more together as time goes on. And then, of course, we're still doing the collab stream with Spooky Snacks on Wednesday nights, unless she's got something else going on. It just really depends. If she's got something going on, like a game that I don't have, then me and Miku will probably stream something of our own together or something. Just depends. Or I'll stream by myself.
Yes.
Yeah. Whatever we feel like is going on at the time. So anyway. So.
And Monday is always a stream that I do alone. So.
Yes.
Come and watch when you want.
So
you got
yeah.
The time.
So yeah, tomorrow it's what is it? Two? No, what did we say? I don't remember. I have to look at the schedule. But
I'm going to be playing Halo Combat Evolved on...
Yeah, Monday, tomorrow.
On Monday, yeah.
So, yeah, that'll be cool. And if I'm available and not at work, I will try to be there as her mod and... Or one of her mods. I know you're also on her mod list, Techno, I believe. But she'll do that. Her schedule is posted in her Discord, and my schedule is also posted in Discord, and they pretty much sync up on a lot of the days. So except for Monday. Monday is the day that I kind of take a break, and she streams alone. But if I'm off and home, I'll be there hanging out in the chat and possibly in voice as well, like we are now. So yeah. So I don't know if you have anything going on. I've been talking my head off.
I was just having people just listen to you as well.
So, yeah, it's been a lot of fun. I like doing this kind of thing. I didn't know for sure if I was going to be able to do this. I'm upgrading my computer this tax season. So, I also need to get with you on that, Techno. I know you told me some models the other day, but I never remember those model numbers like you do. So, I know... that there's several of them that I'm interested in, and I will probably go to something that's not super expensive, but I'm going from a sixth generation quad core to a hopefully a 12, like a six core, or maybe an eight core. I don't know. Whatever the, I'm not even sure the options now, because it's been so long since I've actually built one for myself. This computer that I have right now, I built, it was back in 2015 that I built this thing, I believe. 2015, 2016. I did that way back then, and this thing has been a monster and tearing up all the games that I wanted to play all this time, but I've only just now started noticing a little lagginess going on in certain things. VR chat, for one, on occasion. If I reboot and come back up and run VR chat, it usually works fine, but there are occasions when I get some problems, so... So I'm looking to do that update this tax season and get a whole new motherboard, processor, and RAM. And then I'm going to keep everything else that I have hardware-wise and go from there. And then probably next season, I will upgrade some VR stuff. So hopefully VR will have improved and a bunch of new brands will be available. And we'll see what I can come up with then. So anyway, but I think we're going to call this for the evening. I don't know how many folks we've got in chat at the moment. Oh, we got a few people. I might try to find somebody to raid real quick here. Let's see. I don't have a whole lot of folks, but see if I can... Bear with me a second, y'all. I'll see if I can pull up a... if y'all got any raid suggestions, let me know. So let's see what we got here. I don't know who all is on at the moment. So I think Miku is about to end her stream. So we'll both be getting off of here. Let's see, who can I raid? Wow, this time of day hasn't have a whole lot of folks on that I know. Yeah, wow, I don't really know many of these folks. Well, I have Autumn. Wow. Yeah, I don't even see anybody that I really know in here that's actually online at the moment. Wow. Yeah, I guess we'll just end. Wow. I don't know if I don't see anybody that I could really raid at the moment. So, yeah, I guess we'll just call it for the day, guys. I appreciate you guys stopping by. You know, like I said, we're just doing a little impromptu VR chat hangout session and kind of familiarizing some folks that might not know much about VR chat, and just chilling out in different worlds and, you know, checking things out. And so next Sunday we'll be doing the same thing, myself and Miku, and we will, tomorrow Miku will be doing a stream by herself playing Halo Combat Evolved. So you guys go check her out. That is Hot Miku Bot at, Twitch. And, she's also on YouTube as Hot Miku Bot as well. So you guys go check her out. And I will see you guys on Tuesday night for Untamed Tuesday, starting at 9 p.m. My set for DJing will depend on what DJs we have. So the show starts at 9. That's 9 p.m. Central. So if you want to catch that show, check out Hot Miku Bot stream, because she'll be live from the beginning of it till about 2 a.m. So you guys have a great week. And as always, folks, game on.